Thank you for the introduction. Okay, hi all, thank you for joining, and thanks for the team to organize and put together this conference. So when I first discovered Epic, and I was already a bit familiar with FPPS, and I was like thinking, oh, is this thing that I studied at university that, you know, no one really understood and no one really implemented? And then I was like, do I have to still continue reading those typing rules? But turns out that no, we don't need any of that to use Effect and to learn Effect. So today, instead of going through things like this, I'm going to give you kind of like a mental model of what Effect is and why we might want to use it. So something that I've read somewhere and really resonated with me a lot is that Effect is kind of like a meta framework for TypeScript, as we have meta frameworks for React, for example. And it's meant to take TypeScript to the next level. So let me explain why. So when your app grows in complexity, our code complexity and like the difficulty of managing the code grows too. So Effect for me is perfect to help write like all the complex stuff like async code, to compose code, concurrency, observability, and it also makes dependency injection way, way easier. So on top of all of that, on top of like making this, like writing this kind of code easier, it gives you type safety out of the box. So let's take a look at this code. It's not too many lines, but every single line in this code can throw. And it's not even the most complicated logic there can be. And, you know, like the truth is that I don't really know how it can throw, like what kind of errors. Like maybe some of those functions won't, but in order to know that, I would have to read the code of these fetch ingredients and prepare dish functions line by line. So this managing of side effects and errors in predictable and type safe way is quite challenging. So I really like explaining things through metaphors. So here goes one. Imagine you are at a restaurant, and now what if you order the dish and one ingredient is missing? Like, or maybe they don't have a dish that you wanted to order. Like, should they just close the restaurant and say they don't work anymore? Well, probably that's not what we expect. So one thing that we can do is to try to recover from a failure and maybe somehow retry from scratch what we were doing. But with this code, with this particular code, we can't magically go back to where we were and do something different. So you wouldn't expect that in a restaurant. You wouldn't expect kitchen to start completely from scratch when one ingredient is missing. So now, what if you want to retry with different options? Like, imagine handling all of that with just pure JavaScript and TypeScript. Like, that could end with quite a mess. So what if instead we could communicate? What if we can ask for guidance and to like offer alternatives and do things differently? And that's what Effect is designed to handle, like easily and in a type-safe manner. So like how I like to think about it is like when writing code, like non-Effect code, defining what needs to be done and how side effects need to be handled is kind of like coupled together. You can return errors as values, but then you need to process them right away. So now, what do you think about it differently? Because handling exceptions is not the same as handling errors, because everything in software can safely error. It's part of that. But the question is how we paint those errors. And throwing them as exceptions and like canceling the computation is just one of the options. So what if we disconnect the two? That's the mental model I like to have when thinking about Effect. That we can have these composable blocks, and one of them is defining what needs to be done, and another one is defining how the errors should be handled and what we want to do when the error happens. And those are like two important bits of effect for me. So now let's look into the code and creating effects. So I will be operating on like simplified versions, like skipping most of the logic. So here is one of the options. We can see that we can see a function that returns an effect. And here are a few important bits. So firstly, we declare that this effect will succeed with an array of strings. And another part is that it will, if it will error, it will error with a custom ingredient error. So this custom ingredient error looks like this. I can use this data from effect and this tagged error and extend and create a class that extends it. So later on, when I want to catch this error, I can use one of the many utilities that effect provides. One of them is catch tag, so I can directly say that, oh, if there is an ingredient error, I want to do something in particular. And then another thing is that we can use pipe to create effects, so we can chain more than one effect together. You can also use generators. I'm coming from more like functional programming background, so this resonates more. And what you can notice here is that this effect returns a string and it never errors, because maybe when we want to replace our missing ingredient, we always have some cauliflowers as a backup. So now it's time to run some code. So this is how you can do this. If you have a sync code, you can use effect run sync. And if, not sure if you noticed, I used effect.log, which is built in. So I will see something like this in my terminal. And then let's talk about another common scenario. What if you're at a restaurant and the waiter comes and you are not ready yet? So what now? Would you expect them to just wait, stand next to you and like neglect all the other customers? Or would you expect them to be like, oh, I'm giving up, I won't, you know, serve this table anymore? Or maybe you would expect the person to retry and give you some time. So this is how we can do this with effect. Here, I'm using this retry or else function, which takes an effect as a first parameter, like something that actually has to be retried, executed. And then the next thing is policy. I'm setting it using this schedule library, and I'm saying that it has to retry 3 times with a delay of 100 milliseconds. And if still after, you know, retrying 3 times, we still have a failure, this will fall back to effect.fail. So this is how my function that I want to retry looks like. So the difference that you can see here is that there's effect.async, because it's supposed to be an asynchronous computation. And this takes, there's a callback, there's a function as a first parameter, and I'm resuming in case of error with effect fail and with customer not ready error in one case, or with dish missing error if, for example, a dish is missing. And if something, if everything is right, I'm succeeding with the final dish that the customer ordered. Okay, and now another thing that I wanted to mention is dependency injection. So let's imagine that we operate in different restaurants, they have different ingredients. So we would like to provide them before running our computation. So here I'm declaring, do I have it highlighted? Yes, I do. So the first thing is to create a class that where I'm declaring what kind of properties are there in my service. This class extends the context.tag from effect. And then the next step, if I want to use it, then I'm running this pipe, for example, if I'm going with pipe. I'm using it on the kitchen class. And another thing that you can notice is that I'm passing kitchen as the third generic parameter to the effect type. And that will say that, okay, this is an effect that returns an array of string in case of a success, an ingredient error if an error happens, but it also requires a kitchen service. And then how I provide it is with this provide service that firstly takes the effect and then the class, and I have to specify everything that I previously specified in the class as important. So in summary, so I'm very annoyed because the font doesn't work like it used to look nicer on my computer. So I spend a lot of time choosing the font, so that is annoying. So in summary, effect gives us a safer way to code without using exceptions and model absence of things, and it also allows us to compose functions in a type-safe way compared to untyped JavaScript promises. It's not a free pickup. It's a meta framework, so it does require some initial effort to learn it, of course. And but the thing is that it's still worth it. Like, how powerful effect is worth this initial effort. So thank you.